Oh, I didn't know it had dashes. My bad.
But you need HTTP for it to become a clickable link. Otherwise, I can't just click.
No, but they can copy paste it.
Yeah, but that's look at them. Look, Voodoo's already professional over here, man.
All right, I'm here. What's up? Okay,
so what's up is we're gonna be flipping the card to see who else.
My game's over.
On the side, so. Switch. So
you toss me
Apo
the mic.
As the first pick, head or tails? Apo. Oh. Damn, you guys.
What?
Somebody on his team call it for him.
We're calling tails. Hippos calls tails.
Tails. Alright, so let's flip it. And, oh my god, it's actual tails. So what side do you want to start guys on?
Let's take blue side.
Every game in
Worlds was won by the team on blue.
That's logical. I like it.
Okay. It's true. Well, at least in the finals, in the championships, every team, or every time SKT won, it was on blue side. Well, there's got to be some logic there.
That's definitely good motivation. So we will let you guys hear and go to our own channel and let us know when you're ready to roll.
Yeah.
Yep.
And since we are here now with out the team actually present in the room, so welcome my new shoutcaster for this game. For these games, it will be your favorite mod, Litoche.
Oh, I'm definitely the favorite. We all know that, but you know, shh. How you doing, Voodoo?
I am doing really good, and I am really excited for this game since the Fabulous Five is playing, and it's supposed to be playing another team, community team, but they decided when they saw us that they're not as fabulous as Momentum Gaming, so they decided to disband. So it came down to Glow to put together some team that is
That is going
to be taking the challenger part. So I, for purposes of this stream, I decided to call them the all-star team. So this game, it will be MG Fabulous 5 against MG All-Star. And it's not really all-star, it's just what Glow managed to scrap from the bottom of the barrel. I mean, I didn't say anything. It's totally all-star. So, right now, the teams are switching their positions in the lobby. So, as soon as they are ready, we will start, we will have a look.
Semi invites, I don't think I have them.
Ooh, yeah, that would be a good thing to have a showcaster in the spectate, right?
That is so true, that is true.
And do I have you somewhere?
Yeah, I just sent you a message.
Oh my gosh, I'm so bad. Really? That's your name?
Yo, okay. Okay, no. I can't use my actual account right now, so I have to use this, so just okay. Don't.
I invited you.
So alright, I feel judged already.
Switch to the spectate mode. Well, no one will see it, thank God. So... So don't you worry.
I think we're waiting on one more. So wait, is Matt being a spectator as well?
No, he will be switching the room with me since I am the owner of the rooms so far. So when we have the fourth person there, I will just transfer it to a glow and we will be good to go.
I see.
A glow go. I like that. And you know, you need to pat yourself because no one else is going to do it for you, so well.
Fab Fiverr's All-Star. Everyone in chat's like, I don't even know what's going on. I think I don't even know like what their name should be. Like, yeah, I guess we'll keep it All-Stars. But I think that, how many teams do we have? Do we have two or three?
Oh my gosh, you are a moderator. You should be totally up to date on stuff like this.
No, I know. I've been away for the holiday, so I'm not 100% sure. But like, how many do we have?
Right now, we have four teams that are assembling, and we will have a sixth team total by end of the January. So for those of you guys that actually are watching the stream and considering joining, there will be a silver gold team forming after the holidays, and there will be a diamond plat team forming. So if you want to participate in those teams, then head into the team sign-up channel and put your IGN, your role, and when you are able to play, and you will see if you get picked up by one of the captains for the new teams. But the goal is that we have two teams from each ELO. So right now we have two teams from Bronze, Silver. We have two teams from we have one team from Silver, Gold. We're waiting for a second Silver, Gold. We have a Plat team, and we'll be waiting for the second Plat team. So those teams will be skirming against each other. We have some other communities that are interested in playing with us, so that will be going on.
That's pretty cool. All right, so yeah, okay, so we have a lot of teams. I was just looking in the chat really quickly, and just to let you know, Bag of Bees decided to name the team called, so it's MG Fabulous 5 versus Bees in the Four Feeders. So,
oh, that's shame. They should decide that. they already All-Star, and we'll see if they can stand up to the name.
We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. All right, so do we have our person in here? Oh.
So we are waiting for a last person to get into the lobby right now. And as soon as that happens, we will be starting. And oh my god, we actually have 12 people there, which is less than at the beginning. There was 21.
14. You know what? Here, I got you guys.
14. Oh, that's rising. So for the people that just joined us, hi guys. You will be watching the game of MG Team Fabulous 5 against the MG All-Star team led by our heroic leader Glowstick. Which he decided to, since the other team was too scared of us and they disbanded, he decided to keep you guys entertained, have that one game going, and he put together a team so the Fabulous Five have someone to play against.
Alright.
And it looks like one of the team members that was supposed to be playing for a team of Fabulous Five is missing in action.
Do you want to send me over to Fabulous Five and I can check and see what's going on if they need any help?
No, we should be. Because
I literally can't get in there. Right.
So right? The teams are actually taunting each other in the lobby. That's like they're going to be played for V5. And I mean, come on, that will be totally good since Fabulous 5 playing with 4. The All-Star team has Matt and Glowstick there, so they basically playing. That's basically a three-man team right there. And no, I'm just kidding. Glow is totally awesome AD carry, and I don't know what Matt is going to be playing, but I'm sure he's awesome with it as well. So we are waiting for that to happen. But I don't know, guys, if you actually saw our new intro video. So for those of you who didn't see it yet, we will be playing it right now. So it's really short. It's just around 15 seconds. But I hope you guys enjoy it. So here it goes. And we're back, and as I said, it's just 15 seconds. It's really short, but it's supposed to be in front of our YouTube videos. It's going to be there in future. If you have any recommendations or improvements for that, just direct message me and we will see what we can improve on it. And hey, we have a full team in the lobby right now, so let's see if we can actually start the game. And we've been on the beginning of the stream. I was actually flipping the coin, and Fabulous 5 won. They tipped heads. They tipped tails, and the coin landed on tails, so they got to pick a side. They picked the blue one with a logic of SKT1 always won worlds when they were starting in blue, so I guess that's they will have that going for them. I mean, superstitious.
You know what? I've got a question for you, actually. So, out of these two teams, which one do you expect? Which one do you think is gonna win? Like, I'm ready. Picking favorites. Do you wanna like bet on this? What do you think?
I don't know. I seen some of the members of the All-Star team playing, but I haven't seen a single. I've seen only one game from Fabulous 5. So I'm kind of leaning towards the Fabulous 5.
Okay.
But I hope I will be really they will just give me a nice surprise and we will see actual 3 games, not just 2 games steamroll.
Mhm.
And okay. It looks like there is a final ready check going on in the room. So it looks like that someone is watching the stream.
Whoa, ghosting, they're ghosting, guys.
That will not be a problem since there will be actual 3-minute delay on the game itself, so it will be useless for them. But it's nice to know that even the players are getting ready, they need to be focused, they still find the time to watch our stream. And we are in the lobby. Banning phase is
if I must.
The first ban is Evelyn.
Going.
Followed by a Lux. That's definitely unusual right there. And I'm getting messages. And okay, nothing important. So we've seen the previous games that MG was playing. We've seen Deluxe.
Chaos will follow. So
there's always another
she
way.
She has the potential to one-shot people in the beginning of the game if she gets it steamrolling. She falls off in the late game. Really easy to assassinate. But in the meantime, we've seen Renekton and Nami ban.
Yes, sir.
Oh boy, and I think the Teemo is just for troll.
Well, I don't know what actually they're
impure
planning. Impure fools. That was that's the actual first pick that, and that I was glad to see. And the first lock in, insta lock in to be precise, is
Camille.
On,
and then obviously Bard for Bag of Bees. We all know how good he is with Bard.
Yeah, but he is not as good as me. Wink, wink.
Wink, wink, not
because I am the unspoken kink of the Bard place in this Discord. No, just kidding. you don't want to go into my stream and see the sick Bard place that I have there.
All right.
so enough of the self-advertisement.
We have the go ahead
there, and actually changed to Malzahar, and surprise, the Glowstick pick a best fortune.
Well, Glowsticks and I had a game earlier. It was pretty much press R, 100-0 their team. It's good, you know. MF is ready. She's really, actually, really strong this patch, I think, in my opinion. Between her and like Caitlyn or Vayne, late game, I think MF sometimes out damages Vayne. I'm not gonna lie on that one. At full build.
Yeah, it depends on how rolling they are. In the meantime, we saw pick up Amumu by Summoner, which is the lovely hippo, as you know him from our Discord. Followed by Orianna.
All right. By the way, we didn't say this before, but the choose for Bard got switched out for Xerath. And then we're seeing a Leona come in here.
That is a really nice pick. I think the in a last patch since start of the season, I saw a lot of Leona being played as a support. It's like a lot of people are going tanky now.
Mm-hmm. Well, when they updated the masteries, we got that new one, Bond of Stone, I think. No. What's it called? Yes, Colossus. I'm sorry. That one, yeah. And they get the shield. I think that's honestly a really broken one. Are they actually going to choose Urgot here?
Yes.
You know, if they actually choose Urgot, I will. No.
Yeah, they want that tank shredding potential.
Oh my goodness.
Engage. That is an Lulu support.
That's a great pick. Yeah, that's a good pick against Vi, because then Vi can't burst the AD carry down as fast. Or anyone that shields.
It's the same. It's a really good pick against Leona as well into the lane, since Lulu has really good poke potential against Leona. And, I mean, of course, Leona can try to passage to her, but since the Lulu increased movement speed and her slows, she has if the player has a good reaction times, then that should be easily avoided. And Lulu was a lock followed by a Jhin, so we know Fabulous Five team composition for now, and we are waiting for that last pick from All-Star team right now.
All right, here we go.
And will we see Eloy? Funny trivia effect. Eloy was a Gangplank's first love, in case you didn't know.
Honestly, I don't. Do you follow the lore a lot, out of curiosity?
Yeah, it's in Gangplank's lore that Eloy was his huge crush and lover and stuff. So, and she is locked in. So we have for Team Fabulous Five, we have locked in Camille, Amumu, Rihanna, Lulu, and Jin on the bot lane.
Versus MF, Xerath, Leona, Vi, and of course, Gangplank's love, Illaoi.
So we will see how that is going to turn on. And I took the liberty, since we will now have 3 minutes before the game actually starts, I took the liberty of preparing some totally random, not targeted at specific person whatsoever. Statistics, yay! Statistics. So,
I took
the liberty of looking at the Save the Hippos, which in this case is the summoner playing a summoner named Summoner, with playing Amumu, you know, just so you guys are in the picture. And look at that. I mean, this is looking really interesting at first glance. But I want to disregard this and disregard the 35% win rate, because that's not that doesn't matter whatsoever. But I would like to focus on the actual picks, since you can see that he was playing out of the jungle roles. He's playing jungle. So he had there Rengar, Shyvana, Poppy, and he picked Amumu, which I think is really interesting, since Shyvana and Poppy, I think, on this patch have a much bigger impact on the game than Amumu. I mean, granted, it's a really good combo that they have right now with Orianna, since Amumu, Bandage, ult, followed by Orianna, ultimate. And that's just nice free targets for Jin's grenade and his curtain call. So that is really nice. But at the same time, they will group up to execute that. And that works perfectly for Eloy, because Eloy just wants that big, massive target to just smash upon. So we'll see. I think there is quite a bit of counter engages possible right there, and it will be whatever. I think it's like those team fight 5v5 potential is really equal, and it will just depend on which team will be able to execute the initialization first.
Yeah, no, that's definitely a good comment on that one. But I think it should be okay if they can pull it off. If they're that coordinated and they can actually get it done, that the Amumu, the Orianna, the Amumu ult can be very strong, because that can take out, like, okay, if you think about it, Amumu's ult does a lot of damage, plus all of his abilities. If he can get everything off at once, they probably can kill at least 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 people just with that alone, right? If that leaves them grouped up too much for Illaoi, then I don't know what to say about that one. They might. That's definitely a lot to look at. But we'll see what happens, honestly. For you, are you loading?
Yes, I'm loading into the game. And here we go. now people can see it as well. Yeah, and on the other side, it's they have the Fabulous Five has a great combo right there, and but the All-Star team has a good combo, of course, as well, because it's Leona's ultimate followed by Elias' ultimate, MF ultimate into it, and that's just like, if executed properly, that can be GG. So
one thing that I've actually noticed is if you get the I know they don't have a Camille on their team, but if you get the Camille and she ults one of their targets, usually MF can kill them with that if Camille goes down, as long as they ult within there. And that's another interesting combo.
So we're in the game. We see that the All-Star team is actually decided to start on the red. So Vi will be Vi will be starting at her blue. So will be a Mumu, played by a Hippo. I was actually waiting if we will see some crazy plays going from the beginning, but it doesn't look like that is going to be happening.
I don't see very much warding going down. I think they're all just kind of saving their stuff.
Yeah, we have, for several months now, the lane swaps aren't a thing anymore. There's not even in the LCS we haven't seen deep vision wards growing.
Not even deep, just on what's it called, like entrances to the jungle to make sure that no one's invading and stuff like that. But that was some really good damage down by Orianna to Xerath. I don't know if you had that on there.
Oh yeah, we do actually. We tested. Oh, that's a lot of damage going on from Jhin right there, and some poking on top on the Illaoi. The mid laners just trying to go on it. Jhin, everyone wants to get that.
First blood.
It's 400 gold.
Yeah, that is a lot.
It is a lot. And regarding if we actually see the same stuff, we do see the same stuff. We tested it with the globe. As long as you have it on directed camera, we will see the same thing.
Okay, perfect.
And this is interesting, since this is that was a flash Q from Redomi to secure a first blood on the glow stick. That sucks. So 3 minutes in, and that was a first blood secure. We will see a Q combo coming on the Xerath and flash burnt by Back of Beast to escape that. Definitely a good gank right there. We will see if Hippo repeats it before the flash timer comes up again. He should have a time for that, since it's a really long cooldown.
So we'll see if we get a repeated gank on mid, or Vi might try to come in for a counter. Oh, 1 second. I'm fixing up my scoreboard. I don't know if you've done it to match like top.
It's O. Scoreboard. if you hit O. It's
oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
It's gonna stay open.
Sorry, guys. I don't spectate very often, so I'm still learning as well. So Vi's in there taking red buff, and we're on bot lane again. They've got a lot of damage down.
Preparing for a gank. Orianna is pushed up. That is a lot of damage going on.
Baez got the red buff. Her Q should reset.
Ooh. And that was kill secured by Zeratul. That was really nice to die.
Camille going top. She's got her shield. Dueling Lowy. And Lowy walks away, it seems.
Yeah, just to disengage. Matt on NPC engage from Red Dog.
This Vi is everywhere right now.
And Lulu just running for her life, but that shield and heal had to be burned by Dom. That will be a kill for Vi. Oh, that root. Can the trap? No, there was actually Vi still had the potions to burn through, so that will not be a kill for the Fabulous 5.
Okay.
But that was a really close. Vi got away with barely 10 hit points. And we have a game on going on top lane. Amumu, will he land his Q? That is one death alloy right there. No cooldowns had to be burned. And Matt saw that he will be dead anyway, doesn't matter what he wants to do, so he saved himself the flag for the next time, which is totally a good decision at this point. And we see a Vi coming from a dry bush on the top lane behind Camille. And
I'm coming to get you.
He is charging flash and followed by a second flash.
Ooh.
Nice. that would be nice tower dive. Let me correct myself. That would be nice tower dive if Vi managed to survive. But Camille just. That's a nice dodging from Corgi. And yeah, Camille managed to trade 1-for-1 in top lane. Zerat's ultimate so far didn't yield any tangible results. And in the meantime, on the bot lane, that is the Lulu poke. And slow.
Lulu laying down some really nice damage on glow sticks.
Yep, that's what we have been talking about before the game started. And, that is Lulu trying to gank, but thanks to Shulk maintaining the position in the river, it was not successful.
Okay, there's a fight link going on top lane.
That is some nice fight. On the top lane.
The Camille is very hungry. She definitely wants to fight. You can see that she really does.
And
they're doing some really nice trades here.
That is all going on the boat, but Camille actually just executes. Ultimate burned by a Amumu, counter engaged by Q, and that did not pay off to re-engage. We see a TP going on from the top lane. Orianna managed to secure the kill on Misfortune.
Camille popping down.
Finished the Vi, and Camille is now chasing Zerat. The dragon was triggered, so Zerat actually managed to escape since the initial knockout damage, but he was spotted by the vision cone and is being chased down by Corgi. We'll see if the beast managed to get executed, but he's being flanked by Poppy and executed. Sorry, not executed. Killed by Orianna. That was a really nice fight in the boss lane, and what it triggers was Eloy missing his E. Eloy missing his E on the top lane, which gives a huge advantage in any duo. That if you are playing against Eloy, she misses her E on you. You go in because That's a lot of her damage down.
That is, it's definitely a lot. Oh, there's a fight going on top, but she got marked. There's a lot of minions. Camilla's just not having any of it. She's taking everything. Oh, and her dodges are on point too.
Yeah, it's that is a really unfortunate for strategy for Matt, since oh my
and
god,
she gets
double kill. The slows. I mean, many people don't realize it, but if you decide to skirmish with the champion, you wait in solo lane, you wait for two scenarios. And that is a grouping called going down, targeting destruction. It's being body blocked by shock, counter engaged on Lulu. But it looks like Glowstick with the shock just going to disengage and try to save their lives. But as I was saying, you want to wait for the minions to either be an equal amount.
Oh, Lowry's coming in. He senses something's going on. Let's see if he does an ult and sees. Yep, gets a Moomoo.
Question is, can he get the Riftrail?
I think he's got a really small spot, so I think if you can ult, he. Ooh.
So that
and Camilla just got some.
Yeah, that is trade 1-for-1 kill wise, and Camilla managed to secure herself the Rift Herald. So overall, I think trade in favor for Fabulous 5.
So looking at the score here, we've got 10-4. Fabulous 5 is definitely killing it here. Their combos are amazing. They've got some really good stuff going on. Oh, and we just got a Shockwave miss. An ult coming in.
Ooh, that, yeah, that's,
and
that's
a bag of bees got Corgi. That's one more kill for them.
Yeah, that was a definitely a bit too cocky from a Corgi mistake to be staying in lane with that amount of hit points. And we might see a first power gold going to Fabulous 5. Indeed, that's 50 gold.
I think we're going to see another kill as well. Camilla's definitely on the strong side right now. She is 7-1. She's just completely dominating top lane at this point. Oh, we got an engage on Lulu. The ult missed. We got a polymorph. And we've gotten a Moomoo and a Vi coming in bot lane. So it is a 3v3. It is very fair. MF starts her ult. Clears
the mist. Everyone. And Moomoo is just on a cleanup duty. They completely die. And they hold the power, extra damage from power. Unfortunately, that is still 1v2 trade on both lane. And in the meantime, Camille
on top side. She's still going in.
Yeah, Galliant is just going ham. He gets two kills. Power, and now he's dueling with Aloy again. The shield from Orianna there for the assist and the kill. And that will be inhibitor tower. Maybe. And no, Glowsticks managed to get there in time. And the Dome with the Domi are trying to secure the first two dragons of the game with the Cloud Drake, and without much of the problem without the Fabulous 5.
So it's 13 minutes in, 15-6, 25k to 17k. Blue team is definitely up by a lot. If we look at the farm differentials here as well, Camille's got 106 farm versus 69 on Alawi. Jin is also up by 30 farm, up against Glowsticks.
Yeah.
Leona's got 15 farm though. She's out farming Lulu. And Ori's also out farming. Everyone on the blue side is farming very well. The red side is definitely farming well as well. But they are just definitely not catching a break.
And that was Back of Beast ultimate interrupted by Moomoo, but he don't get himself deterred. He just throws a spell save and finds that low hit points Corgi still being there even after successfully dodging all the shots.
We've got Camille here now. She's trying to go for the tower. We've got three people mid. It's 3v2.
Speaking of form, you were saying that Leona has a 15, now 19 form. That's new, but she is getting that number because she has a relic shield. So she
I know. CS.
But Lulu has that is a lot of damage going on with glow sticks, followed by bullet time from MF, turn it around, and Leona still have the empowered auto attacks. And,
she's going in for that stun.
Evil land, Q followed, and she will secure the kill. In the meantime, in the mid lane, Glory gets killed. Really unfortunate. Camille with that insane jumping around. Can't be engaged on that by.
Amumu misses his Q, so we ult to secure the kill.
mean, it's like. If your Q misses, you always have that ridiculous Lirage ultimate that just carries the day anyway. And let's have a look on the gold distribution. By the way, that's if you hit X, it will switch into the gold of the champions.
Okay.
So we right now see on the top lane the huge difference of Camille having 8,300 gold versus
4,200.
Is a 4,000. That is just huge. And the gold on supports pretty much even on the bot lane, even though that there is a 20 CS difference between the AD carries. And Camille,
we've got a 2v1 here.
One doing, and looks like
I don't think she's gonna get out of this one.
She still might.
Oh,
oh my god.
And she gets a one kill out of that. Yes. Alright, I will give her that.
Camille managed to go even in that trade. That is amazing. And I think that's partly due to people not being ready. And there is going to be a tower dive, looks like. And actually, Orianna and Lulu are trapped between the Xerath and the botlane tower, and that will be a little ulting. Close to just
and the gym follow up.
The critical shot from the dome, and that is a 3 kills for dome. And Matt has to flash, but it will not be enough since he was followed by Amumu's Q and Orianna's slow. Really, really unfortunate right there. So, right now the score is 21-11 in favor of Fabulous 5. And Fabulous 5 has
almost a 10k gold lead, wow. They've got 3 towers as well. Next dragon up is very soon, a minute and a half at least. But
and in 2 minutes, we'll see Baron coming into the play as well. That could really turn tides. If All-Star team manages to secure themselves the Baron,
you will be where I want you to be.
Then they would be able to.
And Camille's just going in, taking the kills. Vi's behind her though. Vi can't 1v1 her at this point though. She's a little bit too much. It's definitely gonna take at least one or two.
1v1 her at this point since she's 11 and 2. So
oh yeah, definitely.
All Vi can hope so is just scary her away.
Yeah, she does not look damaged at all. She's level 13, everyone else is about level 10.
And so the Camille managed to drag the attention from the mid lane, so Hippo and Corgi were able to secure the mid lane tower for them. Huge progress, since that will allow them to open a game open the playfield quite a bit for them.
One of the things that I really do want to say is red team has a lot of wards in their jungle. They're doing a great job on warding. Blue team, it looks like Camille is doing most of the warding. Oh wait, no, I do see a couple of blue ones also. So they do have some really deep wards on blue side. Red side is definitely doing some stuff.
On the engage, unfortunately, summoner on Amumu missed his Q.
Bandage.
Bandage.
And we see Jin dancing a little bit. Oh, Camille's coming in for the stun.
Camille just jumps over the wall.
Even though she gets CC'd after everything, she's still no problem. Oh, she's going in for the 1v4.
Yeah,
her team starts looking for backup.
Amumu
finds the bandage. Lands his ult. Jin snares. Alawi ults. Oh my goodness. Lulu ults. There's so many ults being thrown everywhere. Amumu finds another bandage, but he is definitely low.
We will see how dumb is this shocker. That will be... Ooh.
We'll see if he's American Sniper today.
Yes.
And there we go.
Yeah. That was the burn from his keystone.
Deathfire.
Deathfire touch. And secures the kill. What
you will learn
unfortunate truth beginning of the game. And we are 20 minutes in. The Orianna on the mid lane for her life, and then we're getting executed. Glowstick manages to secure himself a kill on Orianna. That's not a first time Corgi and his Orianna were somewhere they're not supposed to be with the amount of points they have. But, hell, no one's perfect. So at this point, with the slightly over 10,000 gold lead, the Fabulous Five is just forming. They retreated a bit from the red side jungle. How do you think this game will affect the bans? For
game two, honestly, in my opinion, really quickly, we see Camille trying to go in. It's a 4v1. Vi's there. Oh, Camille gets through the wall. I think she should be safe for that one. For the next game, honestly, blue team wins. I think it should push them to want to do a lot better for the next game. And they, heck, it might just make them do amazing, and they might, like, do the same thing to them, end the game at like 25 minutes, and it'll be a great game. But if blue keeps on going like this, they might start to get too cocky and start throwing, you know what I mean? There's always so many possibilities.
Yeah, and I actually think that for game number two, we will definitely see the Camille ban going.
Oh, yeah.
And
we see an engage on Amumu. We got an ult on Leona, but Leona didn't get
anything. That is what we were talking about.
That's exactly what I was saying, but then again.
By his ultimate Orianna ult right into it. That is...
Camille wasn't even in that fight. It was a 5v4.
Yep. And still overwhelmingly. I mean, that CC was so good change. From them right there. Hippo. Damn, that's an Nexus tower going down. And this.
What are those death timers? About 1 second. I don't think that they'll be able to get it, honestly. They may be able to get. Nope, they're not getting the tower.
the tower, as the fortress said, Alamo. Is going to stand just by force of will. And we'll see if the hitter and his enemy is going to get out of that. Unfortunately,
Definitely not.
Nope, he definitely did not.
But for the last team fight, we still could see that the even though that Matt and his alloy are really behind item wise, there was a still lot of damage going on that four man ultimate that he triggered.
It's he definitely had a lot of it.
I will dare to say that the two kills that I actually managed to secure during that team fight were mainly because of that.
His items are definitely showing. He's starting to build a lot more armor though.
Well,
I think it's mostly for Camille.
He doesn't have really much of a choice since he didn't get snowballing, so the pure AD alloy that is just disgusting, just by the way. I see him a lot playing by Sin, so I know what I'm talking about. And I mean, like, seriously disgusting. We would be 2v5ing the entire team in the late game, like 40 minutes in. But
wow. Anyway,
back to the topic, the alloy, if she doesn't
We might get a catch out here. I think Camille's starting to get a little bit too cocky. Oh, she's out.
She's
but also at the same time, the team is doing
Baron. Baron and Zerat. Bag of Beasts.
Oh, they tried to go for the steal.
But that was bullet time going on. Engaged by Guy. Lulu's ultimate. That will cost her life, but MG Dombell managed to get away. And in the meantime, that's just a back door, and they will prevent the. That is the game.
Yep, Camille is just completely taking it.
Yep. I have to say, I did not pay attention to the minimap. I did not see that the Camille was actually sneaking the back door right there. And that was a game number one going down for the Team Fabulous 5.
So a couple of comments from the stream. Mr. Pixie, if Jin autos his fourth crit auto on a minion, so it looks like he's done that a lot. Another thing is, Voodoo, just to let you know, actually no, I'll message that to you later, but for now, just looking at the comments are pretty funny.
Alright, then let's keep this thing rolling. I'm starting a new lobby right now, so let me just quick hit that confirm invite everyone who needs to be invited and you have the liturgy, you have the invite.
Yep.
So, let's give out those invite privileges. So, what a game! And as the teams are getting ready, let's let's have a look on how did the teams did during this last game. Because statistics are OP. You've been commenting on the Vort's plays, and I'm actually looking on the OPGG on the match. On the match, and there's been exactly a 52 and 52 Vort's placed there by both teams. So that's really nice. And damage dealt to champions. Definite winner in that regard, without any surprise, is Camille with a 19,000 damage. Followed by Oriana with 15,600. And Zerat played by Corgi with 14,300 damage done. So that is definitely really nice to see. Yeah. The total gold in the end, it ended up with a 14,000 gold difference in favor of Fabulous 5. And as we are talking, the lobby is getting ready for game number 2, and here we are. So let's change into the...
I will wait for you to be better.
Unfortunately, my alpha client, or the new client, is misbehaving a bit.
If I must.
Nowadays, unfortunately. So I'm really sorry for all the spectators. And that was a first ban. Camille going to be banned right there, and this is really annoying. Let's see if this fixes it, maybe for a bit. And that is a board ban. We didn't even saw a board going through in a game number 1, and now it's being banned, so that is definitely interesting. Followed by a Lux ban again, and the third ban.
Your emperor shall return.
So we will not see the return of the emperor, unfortunately. The Shurima will not make its appearance on the mid lane, but we will see what will be the final ban from the Fabulous 5 team right now. And dramatic drums.
Nautilus. Not rest.
That's definitely interesting. And we saw a virus being locked in for a glow stick. We'll see if he actually plays it, or if it's going to be just some off meta mid lane pick. And for those of you guys wondering inside of the Twitch chat, yes, this is game number 2 in the best of 3 series. Currently, the Fabulous Five are winning over the MG's All-Star team 1-0. So we'll see if this second game is going to seal the victory for the Fabulous Five, or if the All-Star team will pull some rabbit out of their head, and we will see that third game. I honestly hope we will see the third game. I love to see the third games. And in the meantime, that is Jin and Y locked in for Fabulous Five, and Virus, Syndra, and Mouse over Renekton. We'll see if he gets locked in. Which is interesting, because we have seen Avi being on the opposite team in previous game and did really good. So I totally understand why Summoner is trying to snatch the Avi away from the All-Star team.
How you doing, Voodoo? Sorry about that. I'm back now.
Well, I didn't even notice you were missing.
Feel like he was just like talking to me, and I was like, "Yeah, I'm just ignoring you. Don't worry."
And now we see that mouse over for a Poppy, and we most likely will see some either support on mid lane. Corgi is going for those a place with a Veigar. We'll see what the MG All-Star team response is going to be for that.
Hey Voodoo, just really quickly, I sent you a message on Discord about this as well. But FemC also agrees. Your mic is really quiet on the stream.
Really quiet.
So you should like turn it up just a little bit, because I think in contrast to like this listening volume, it's a lot quieter than that.
Okay, so I just
thank you very much, FemC, by the way.
Yeah, I just... hold on, I need to fine-tune it a bit. Alright, so this should be... I turn it by 250%, so let me know, guys, if it's better or not. And that was Sonya locked in for the All-Star team, followed by Sejuani. And the final pick for game number 2 in this series will be Braum. Because stay behind Braum, louder. Twitch demands to get it louder.
I see. So Mitcha also says something else. He said that he thinks that you're perfect voice, but I'm a bit too loud. So I think it might just be the contrast. And then Paranoid is like you're making sweet love. Oh my god.
If
you were here, I would make sweet love to you.
Oh my god. this channel is supposed to be PG-13.
I'm sorry.
Come
okay,
on, guys.
All right, we'll keep that PG. Sorry, guys.
Okay, thank you for your feedback on the loud noise issues.
I'm starting my car right
now. Yeah, I totally don't know what's going on with that Twitch chat. What Twitch chat? What's going on? What are you talking about? What's going on?
Oh, don't worry, there's secrets.
Shh. Spaghetti. Yes, I would totally like some spaghetti. I'm making a good bolognese spaghetti. Spaghetti with bolognese sauce and Alfredo sauce, really good as well.
Ooh, Alfredo sounds good. Oh my goodness.
Yep.
Voodoo, let's talk about you a little bit. I actually have a couple of questions. Like, what background are you? I'm sorry. I just need to ask you.
A background? What do you mean, background?
Like, Because I notice you have that accent, but I'm wondering, like, what, where are you from?
I am from Czech Republic.
Okay, that makes more sense. All right.
And,
say spaghetti 5 times.
Spaghetti, spaghetti, spaghetti. And for those of you still listening to my lovely and now a deep and seducing voice, spaghetti. was that a spaghetti enough for you?
That was beautiful.
Right, I know. Yeah, so I'm from Czech Republic, currently living in United States of America. Yay! Goes America. See. Fuck yeah.
Wait, aren't you worried about Trump though? Actually,
he's supposed to be kicking out all the illegal guys, not the ones that. That's totally off topic, but
yeah, just for you
guys to,
like,
just for you guys to know, it's like, it took me 2.5 years and around $60,000 just to be sitting in United on the U.S. soil in like fees, lawyers, and crap. So it's like I hope I will not get my entrepreneur visa canceled. Since
that's a lot. Holy crap! Oh my goodness.
Yeah, so back on the topic, we're talking about league here.
Back on topic, yeah. No, for a second there, no politics.
Politics.
Yeah,
sucks.
That's exactly why I was like, wait a second, shit, we shouldn't be talking about. We shouldn't be talking about this. Sorry.
And we have 10 seconds remaining for we this. We do. So
8, 7, 6, 5.
You're actually 3 seconds ahead of me.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm at 0 and I'm going in.
Let's go.
All right. So, what do you think about these matchups?
These matchups are sick. Like totally sick.
Like totally sick. Sick.
Yeah. All right. I'm actually really paying attention to how Matt is playing, since my team and his team are in the same elo, so we will be scrimming against each other. So that will be definitely fun to be actually playing with him, not just commentating on him. And that will be a pool party Renekton, my favorite Renekton. My pool party skins are all my favorite. And welcome to a game number 2. And this is Fly or Die game for Momentum Gaming's All-Star team led by Glowstick. And we'll see, he exchanged his Misfortune for his second most favorite champion, that being Kavaris. He is accompanied by Shulk and his DJ Sonya. And we will see. I for sure hope that with the sustain, we will not see the history repeat itself, and that there will be no first blood on Glow. But look at that. That's actually a Jhin. That's a Dom with Redomi waiting in the Tribush. But they don't look like. Maybe they will be waiting for a Glow and Shulk coming from the leash. If that go through, that will be definitely unfortunate. I think no, they just retreated. They will not risk it. So we will not see any crazy level 1 games. Unfortunately, because we love crazy level 1 games. And they are, of course, totally worth it. I mean, don't let some pros tell you otherwise. Level 1 games are totally worth it. Wink, wink. And since we have Sejuani starting a red on the top, on the bottom,
followed by Crux. She should be a level 3 by the time she finishes with them. So I would
Actually, they fixed that.
Oh, I fixed that?
Yep, red buff and goes into Crux no longer gives you the level 3. That's some good damage now going down on Sona. Plus last that is, and that's a first blood.
That was a fourth. That was a fourth great shot coming in on a shock from a dome, and that was a kill secured. Unfortunately, very, very unfortunate. So this time it they did not focus on Glow, they focus on the poor Sona.
And Glow still has his heal, he still has all of his summoners, and just flashes down for Sona.
That's a really nice poke on the mid lane on Veigar. Unfortunately for Syndra, her stun was on the cooldown, so otherwise that I guess that would be a nice kill. That was a nice prison placed from a Vig from a Corgi to prevent back of beasts moving forward and securing the kill. And that is Braum's passive stun.
Braum, is he gonna get his last one off? Nope.
And that would
is
be MG
gonna get that kill?
We'll find next time on the episode.
Nope.
Of... Okay, in the meantime, that was a vice securing kill on Matt's Renekton. Very unfortunate. Matt was pushed up really hard without any vision in the river and a knowledge, no knowledge about where the summoner in his Vi is at that moment. So. Really unfortunate.
I should have one. There's some nice poking laid down on bot side. Just really quickly, do you think that red side, do they practice a lot or is it a little bit different? Oh, smooth coming in for the buff.
And
Vi going in.
Ooh,
and
that will be a nice kill and buff for Vi. Rip. There.
Yeah, one of those things where it's like, do you guys practice? Because I know that you said you have a team yourself as well.
Oh, we actually did not. The first time we will be actually able to get together will be tomorrow, since so we didn't get all four people that we currently have on the team right now together. And we'll be playing with, we have a couple of ADCs that would like to join on the, that would like to join on us. So we will be playing with a couple of them tomorrow and see. Well, that was a nice arrow going from Glow poking a Dom currently now at 200 hit points. And if... No, Dom is actually backing, but I wanted to say that the flash Q combo from that's a nice stun on Syndra, but the flash Q combo from Sonya would just definitely be a killing blow right there. And by the way, Twitch, how do I sound? Is the voice now okay? Do I sound good?
I'll keep a lookout for it.
And we see pretty much. Let me rearrange the scoreboard so we actually have the people playing against each other in the positions they're supposed to be.
That's why the first thing I was like, oh, we gotta do this.
And so Poppy is 6 CS ahead, and we see a dragon, mountain dragon, being secured by Fabulous 5. Some damage exchanged on well, not really exchanged since Poppy's health bar didn't really move after those auto attacks from Renekton.
Yeah, Poppy's just insanely tanky right now. I don't think there's anything Matt can do against that. They need a lot of help, definitely.
And we see a three-man collapse on the bot lane. And that is a Vi and Braum coming in. Passive landed. They are still fighting under the tower. And that will be...
Wow.
Ooh, nice tower damage. Kill for Sonya. Definitely welcome. Would be better if it was... Yep. Yep, that's what happened when you play against Syndra and she has her ult up. You just see a lot of balls and then nothing. And the TP is going on in for the red side. Poppy is hammering against the wall and that will be kill secured on Sejuani. The grenade and bounces. Curtain call is being called. Sonya will body block for Glow. And... Ooh, Poppy will go for it. Ram it against the wall. Q. And that will
double
be
kill.
Double kill for Jillian. Ooh, but the back of Beast actually showed up. And that was a nice shutdown from Beast Syndra. In the meantime, Matt is taking the opportunity since his TP was on cooldown. He could not join the fight on the bot lane. So he's just trying to do some damage to that top tower. Since the first tower gold is still on the table, there's 400 gold, is pretty big in the beginning of the game, and especially now when Fabulous 5 is some 1200 gold ahead, that would be definitely helpful for All-Star team to secure such objective.
Well, keep in mind this as well, like, the All-Star team, they just literally gathered their people together within, like, the past probably hour and a half.
Yeah, that's totally something we need to mention. The Fabulous 5 is playing together on a regular basis. They have a trainings, team strategy and stuff versus the All-Star team led by Glow. Was just since the last on the last minute the other community teams disbanded, so we did not have the opponent, but we had wanted to have the game anyway. Glow just managed to pull five people that had the time right now and just play together. So even though that they are roughly from around the same elo, it's definitely not equal matchup, at least in the sense of Fabulous 5 having that time to prepare and to get used to playing with each other. But we have a tower dive going in, and oh my gosh, those Syndra plays!
Dive, Syndra was still able to get one, and Agent Smooth is getting another one over here on Sejuani.
And that will be passive proc on. Ultimate missed from Sonya, unfortunately. But that was a really nice defense from back of Beast. Basically outplaying 1v3. Really nice. Thumbs up for that play. A lot of damage was exchanged on the bot lane. And now Pop is just poking Renekton, saying get out of my CS. And
blue team's actually gone back up. They're only down by about 400 now.
We are 11 minutes in, so everything's still possible. The CS wise, we see even though that Galliant had TP down into the bot lane, he's only one CS behind Matt. And Summoner smited, stole the blue. Smooth had to actually flash over the wall. Matt is trying to chase down No, he's not. He will just get outplayed. Never mind. And that was just the disengaged. That of a little skirmish that started over the blue buff. Ridomi and Don clearing that tribush vision. Matt finally having some poke damage so he can just roll in on Poppy, do some damage, stun her, roll out before she can respond with her nice shiny hammer. And let's look on the gold distribution. It's right now, it's pretty equal, only like 800-700 gold separated, but we see 500 gold alone difference on the top lane, even though that Matt is in the lead. And the TP is going through from Poppy. Oh, sorry. That was a Corgi, that was a Corgi on his Veigar, trying to protect the tower, since there's still that first tower gold still possibility. And Smooth is Sejuani jumping over the wall. We'll see if he managed to land the ultimate. Here he goes. Vi has to retreat. Low health points. Brown pays for this with his life. Matt got stopped by Poppy's W from dashing away, but no follow-up damage could be done. The All-Star team secured themselves a Cloud Drake, if I'm not mistaken. So we will see how if they can use that extra power to rotate from one line to another, catch up the Fabulous Five in out of position. And Matt looks like just playing it safe. And in the meantime, Ridomi and Summoner securing the blue. We actually see supports semi-shadowing their junglers. We see a Braum. Ridomi's Braum prepared for a gank on the mid lane, but I think he was spawned. And Poppy smashes Samat against the wall. No follow-up damage there, unfortunately. And Ridomi just moves away from the mid lane as Smooth is coming for a counter gank, since Vi got spotted in their jungle, in her jungle. And everything's basically just compared to the crazy beginning when we saw a shock level 1 dying, granting the first blood. It's pretty equal right now. I mean, we are down to 300 gold difference, and that's just only because how the waves are pushing, since one of the waves is arriving sooner than than the other teams and so forth. So everything's equal right now. Critical from Dawn, and Matt had to flash across the wall. The ultimate had to be burned by Glow. And we see the Chain of Corruption for the next time. And that is a Rift Herald secured by Vi. That was a nice stun landed on the Corgi's Veigar by Bag of Bees. And fight of the skill shots just continues. Matt's trying to chase away the Galleon from his tower. And Galleon will just retreat. Unfortunate for Corgi, he was in a range of B's ultimate. So that is truly unleashed power. A TP going down from Galleon to save the first turret, but Matt will just keep pushing forward, and he secures for himself the solo gold, which is really big. It's 650 gold, gold for the whoever kills the tower locally. And since Matt was the only person of their team present at the kill, he will get. And we have a pause. So, if Litoche is there and wants to jump down, oh no, it actually was unpaused. Never mind.
Oh, the pause is just for a second. I think they were just fixing something.
And we are going again. We see a damage, a root snare landed on a glowstick, followed by the ultimates from both Braum and Sejuani, and this will be a nice arrow from Glow to secure himself a double kill. So right now the All-Star team is actually getting into the lead. That is really, really nice. We'll have in 40 seconds, we will have another Drake. It will be Ocean. And in the meantime, the mid lane is getting kinda out of hand. I mean, back of bees over the 6-0, and Galleon goes ham under the tower. He slams a mat against the wall and just disengage after. Poor Corgi, he always gets to move directly into that stun. I personally don't know who to credit more. And Matt with his ultimate roll stun, and that was a really nice exchange there. And Matt manages to get himself a first kill on his Renekton. I mean, that was a pretty aggressive place coming from Galleon, especially considering that he did not have a turret to retreat to anymore. So he was in the long lane, trying to get aggressive and tower dive Renekton, which in this point gets really. That's unbreakable, and that will be one dead virus right there, secure without much of the issues. Shock actually got stuck in behind the enemy lines, and he follows the demise of his AD carry in quick succession. So this will be uncontested. Excuse me, it will not be uncontested, but the curtain calls is a go, and a blast cone being triggered by back of beast to get away from the curtain call. Unfortunately, Sejuani did not manage to get in the range, got zoned up by Corgi's Veigar, and that is one Ocean Drake going in favor of Fabulous 5. So that is some extra vision secured by all-star team, and Corgi flashes to safety. Smooth and Shockstick decide not to chase, since he flashed into the fog of war, which was a good decision, especially considering the Vi was waiting there. If you want to chase, always chase only if you have a vision of the place where you are going to. Otherwise, you most likely be in glut to entrap. And that will be Galliant smashing Matt against the wall. It's kind of a recurring theme, the core game being stunned by Matt. That's a lot of damage going through from a dome. A shut down by fourth shot, Matt goes down. Galliant is really low on hit points. That is a unleashed power going on Galliant's Poppy, but did not do enough damage to secure kills. So we do have a 2-for-1 trade in favor of All-Star team, and so far it does look like we will see the game number 2. Smooth is just tanking the damage, and Tower just melted under the combined barrage from 4 members of All-Star team. So right now we have that reset that we'll see some bags, we'll see what items the teams will be able to finish. We see Sejuani have a giant's belt, we'll see, and she turns it into the dead man's plate. That will definitely increase the fight potential right there. We have a virus with finished infinity and going for a fire rapid cannon or something like that, or I assume so, since he has zeal there. And right now, on top of Bag of Bees having 8 kills already, Matt is actually managing to defend his top tower really successfully right there. And Back of Bees, Bees Syndra, sorry, my tongue got tangled a bit. Bees Syndra is ahead of 50 CS and 6 kills with still a 0 death. That's a perfect game so far, 25 minutes in. And if I were Fabulous 5, I would really go out of my way to shut down B right now, since that is a really a nice shutdown gold right there. And considering they are 3,000 gold behind, they could definitely use it. But unfortunately, Corgi just got himself cut out by both Smooth, Matt, and the honors were given to Beast to just execute him for his 9th kill. We see some clearing of the vision and the collapse of the All-Star team in the mid lane. We might see if pushing the waves into the tower and then retreating for the quick Baron steal. Baron play, or maybe, but Giant is flanking, trying to flank. He gets himself cut out. Vi is charging on a shot stick and gets that was ultimate going on a glow stick, and Poppy helicopter goes out for some reason. They managed to get that shutdown go on Bag of Bees, trying to chase down the Matt, but I think they just clear out the division right now. They will set up for that Baron. Baron was started, and we'll see how fast it will go down. Sejuani doesn't have her ult, but she does have a smite up, so we could still see the flash. Oh, that was close. The man has the ult, tries to dash away. Smooth will get pinned against the wall. There's CC chain he cannot really do anything about. And Matt should be just running away, but he decides to 1v1 the Braum, and that might just provide a fatal. But Glowsticks managed to go with the his ultimate, which I thought to look up the name for a couple of minutes ago, and I don't remember anymore again. It was Corrupted Chains. Yeah, Chains of Corruption. Even better. So we saw a trade, a 2-for-1, and the tower. So I think we could say that it was in favor of Fabulous 5. We see they're trying to secure themselves a Mountain Drake, which would be a second Drake, which is a really big. It would be 16% extra damage against structures and objectives. On top of the a nice 8% regeneration, a really nice deal. And we see a group of four from Fabulous rushing the bot lane, and they decide to keep pushing. Bag of Beasts is recalling back. He will try to defend the bot lane. Maybe he will manage to get there before they take in Hip Tower, and that will be it, since the Fabulous 5 is deciding to protect their own inhib towers on the mid lane, since they see Glow and Shock collapsing there. But they only push to the wave. They know that they cannot fight this team composition right now, since their ultimates are on the cooldown right now, and the extra stats that the Baron buff provides for both players and minions are quite a lot. And we'll see 3v3 right now on going on. The Braum is getting stunned by Bag of Beasts. He just pops his shield and moves away. Shock is trying to catch up with Corgi, but unfortunately he misses ult. He misses his ult, and he missed his slow there as well. That was really unfortunate. In the meantime, a Poppy is Gallant, and his Poppy is trying to secure the top tower, but Poppy's W prevents a match dust pushing in. There is a ghostly stun, but Gallant is so tanky. Look at that. He's tying down two people from the All-Star team, and that is a four-man ult from coming down from Smooth. Unfortunately, Veigar's ultimate chunked him really a lot, followed by Curtain Call by a Dom, and that is going for Syndra. All shots landed, but it was not enough damage done, and this will cost All-Star team a tower. I am not sure which tower it will be. It looks like it will be the top one, since the entire Fabulous 5 decided to rotate to the top side of the jungle. Corgi is just getting himself that sweet blue buff that he really needs as a Veigar. And now we see just Redomi with the Dom disengaging, backing, and All-Star team has just full their hands really full, just repelling the attack and the minion waves that are right now pushing towards the their base. It's not as bad as if they would have just super minions coming in, especially if those super minions would be backed by Baron buff. But thankfully they did not lose the inhib yet, and the Baron buff already expired. So the we see Fabulous 5 playing 1-3-1, and we see that entire All-Star team is around the mid lane with Matt looking for that way to flank, but they don't know they're actually being flanked by a Jhin and Braum. I don't think they will actually try to pick up a fight. I think they're just in unfortunate position, they will try to just get back safely back to the base. That was a stun landed on Radomir's Braum, but nothing serious. Braum, with his hit points right now, can just shake it off. He already has a Night's Vow, he has a Face of the Mountain, and here goes the Curtain Call, and the bullets go for a glow, and Shock is body tanking everything. Galleon to hammer it smooth against the wall. That's unfortunately a virus being blown out by Vega's ultimate, but that was a nice peel there. The smooth is trying to keep most of the team away from the back of bees, but Matt and Smooth just paid with their lives for a bee to survive. I'm not really sure a bee can manage it home to safely, since he's being cut out, and he just totally missed his spell. So that's a Radomir surviving with barely 200 hit points right there. And right now we have a Shock, Smooth, and Glow ready in the base, trying to defend. It will cost them the inhibitor, but there's not much they can really do about it at this point. They cannot afford the 3v4, even though that the Radomir and Coregiver really low on their hit points. And we have a Mountain Drake spawning. Nice use of a blast cone, getting over the wall. That will be a dragon secured. Smooth will not have a time to get there. And that's something that you don't see really often in solo queue, when teams are going for a dragon, or for the Baron for that matter. The, at least my personal favorite thing to do in this situation as a support, I would flank that pit and either trigger the vision cone or the blast cone that is on the other side, preferably both, so you can see what's inside of the pit and you can deny that easy engage on the potential steal, so from the enemy team, since they would then need to either sacrifice one of their dashes or one of the flash. And since it's late in the game, there's a high chance that the flash is on cooldown at that point. So that is really a useful thing to do, for sure, right there. We see a vision being cleared by both teams. It looks like the Fabulous 5 finished the vision and they might start it? Might? Nope. No. The All-Star team needs to back, since they have a super minions knocking on the door of the Nexus and seeing the three members back in the base. Fabulous started the Baron. We have a TP going in from a Vega. That will be, unfortunately, a dead Sejuani. Curtain Call goes down and a Shock is going to be paying with his life. So this will be a Baron totally uncontested. I was really glad for the opportunity that we might see the game number 3. It doesn't look like we will see it anymore. The Fabulous 5 managed to get together and they just steamrolling. It's really nice. Matt's trying to get rid of that ugly item. And I was never really a fan of Ziziroth. And looks like Matt would not kindly stop moving. And
I don't know how many of you actually recognize the reference of that Vagar's catchphrase from one of the from the Bioshock, but would you kindly do something? And that is a glow being cut out and 1v1 by a summoner. The snare will not land on Sejuani. That was a nice combination from a smooth and B, smooth charging through the wall at the same time as a B landing a four-man stun on the Fabulous Five. And we see a Baron empowered minions charging the midline inhibitor turret. A summoner goes right for the bees. Curtain Call is being called, and that will be a kill for the gym. A smooth, you see how tanky the Sejuani is, but it doesn't matter, here's a dead man being cut out from his own base by four members of Fabulous Five. The Poppy lands the her hammer blow, knocking out that would be shot stick dead, just clearing out so the giant Jellyant has the time to secure the Nat. Actually managed to secure the kill on Jin, but it will not matter. There is too much damage going on from the minions into the Nexus, and unfortunately that will be end of this series with Fabulous Five winning 2-0 against a random pick of Momentum Gaming. What a game.
How you doing, Vitter? Sorry about that. I was having internet issues, kept on disconnecting.
So we just finished the game number two.
Okay, who won for that one?
And you're a shortcaster.
I know. No, I just said I was having internet issues.
Yeah, the Fabulous Five have actually won.
Okay.
And let's see if we can snatch a hippo or someone from their team for post-game interview. Yay, we never done that before. So let's try it. We'll see how it goes.
Oh, hippo.
Hey, yep. Everyone. Congratulating hey. To victory.
Hey,
we're still on the stream.
Thank you.
Hello, stream.
And
hello.
We have here the team, the victorious team, Fabulous Five. How you guys doing?
Good.
How you feel?
Pretty good.
Good. Yeah.
Pretty good.
It's a lot better than I felt at like 20 minutes in that second game.
That was really nice. It was actually we were really intrigued to see.
It was actually fun, guys. I'll play again sometime.
Yep, definitely was fun. We were actually hoping that there would be some chance for All-Star team turning it around, but unfortunately that did not happen.
I thought we lost that second game. Halfway through, I was like, this is over. It was like 9 to 20 or something.
Damn.
It's like 9 to 20.
Yeah, that was a big difference on top lane. It's like Galliant got its steamrolling in the beginning, and that was just Matt getting his stuff together and managing to stand his ground and not give away kills and towers.
I still like the first game, first blood Lulu support. Let's go!
Yeah, that was really nice. That was really nice.
That was pretty good, that cheese, though.
do those get posted? I have to go watch my first blood.
Yeah, this entire stream is recorded.
Nice.
So
I get to go watch my first blood Lulu support.
Yeah, you will see it, even including our nice and totally not salty commentate comments on top of that. So
totally not salty at all. I like it.
Yep. So once and again,
if
guys,
we had won the game, we would have pulled out the Zig support.
Yeah, I was gonna go Zig support. If I was like, screw this, Braum, I want to go Zigs, and they were like, don't do it. I'm like, fuck you guys, I do what I want.
That's not a team attitude that we want to hear.
Plays a sub.
Yeah, but anyway,
hey,
guys,
we did good.
Yeah, you did good. Congratulations! Yeah, no, congratulations for the victory again. And with that, I will say a goodbye to the stream. Thank you for watching. There was around between 13 to 20 people actually watching the game.
That's not bad.
During the those two games. So thank you guys so very much for watching. And I am Voodoo saying goodbye from the Fabulous Five channel right now. Have a nice day.
Oh, the stream was still on.